In 1901, Marconi looked out over this ocean, his imagination running wild. Would his invention, his wireless, really work? It did. And ever since, we've been transfixed by a gadget that magically pulls sound out of thin air. Radio. It's all around us. It never sleeps. And 24 hours a day, it's alive with music and information. Hidden at the other end of the wireless, in dark little rooms filled with dials, buttons, and computers, are the announcers who give radio life. And true to the spirit of Marconi, let their imaginations run wild. Rock Around the Clock is a day in the life of rock and roll radio. The story of some of the world's largest, most influential radio stations, the music that makes them hot, and the cities that are tuned in. Our story is about radio, broadcast live to all time zones, everywhere.
Morning, troopers. Another day, another several hundred dollars.
It's a pre-breakfast announcement, Triple M. A bald spot, hirsute in the extreme, slightly oily of complexion, but a damn fine human being and a man I'm proud to call friend.
Finding out myself, what you call.
Ladies and gentlemen of Sydney, you're listening to 2 Triple M. A station that's not too bad when you get used to it.
At the moment it's 17 as Uncle Doug triples your music on Triple M.
Meet a full-time Australian legend, DJ, comedian, part-time rock and roll star, and a good guy.
And I shall be eternally grateful. Thank you so much. Reciprocity at work. Reciprocity alive and throbbing in the bosom of the audio radiance. And those of us here in the studio this morning.
Doug Mulray's appeal is his wild imagination, his wit, and his uncanny ability to deal with sensitive issues.
Now, the tunes you'll be listening for in the classic rock Tremble Plurg, El Zeppo's Do You Make Her, David Bowie's Space Oddity, and Paul Simone's Loves Me Like a Rock. A song for perverts all over the world. All from the hit year, Andrew, of...
1972, Doug.
1973, I'm sorry, forfeit your left testicle. Why, I tell you, my sweet Babette, you'd better be home soon, my little fluffy chook, my dream panties. I miss you. I need that proximity. I'm sorry, Andrew, you know how I get when I start talking like that. The hormones start rushing and I lose control.
Groove, baby, groove, baby, take what's good for you.
Madame Zelda, Sydney's first lady of morning radio. She's insightful and understanding of the city's need to begin each day with important information, and not just Australian rock and roll.
Only like you for your odor-absorbing charcoal foot pads. True.
On this day, the beaches are quiet. It's a winter morning, and Madame Zelda is in fine form.
Word for the day is Wang Doodle.
Wang Doodle.
Wang Doodle. WHANGDOODLE. Wang Doodle. Have you picked that up? I'll be asking questions later.
I haven't picked it up lately, but what is it?
A mythical bird that grieves continuously. past 8 is the time at Triple M from the sensational new Aussie record to one of the most significant Australian records.
Most significant?
Yeah.
Sure.
Oh, yeah.
Sure.
One of the... No. Let's stop foxing. The greatest.
The greatest?
The greatest Australian record of all time.
The greatest.
Right up there with the Pub With No Beer, the Rude Band, and I'm a Punk.
Yeah.
That last part was accurate anyway.
Don't stand up for cripples on a peak hour bus. I'm a punk. He's a punk. I never have my mum do the washing up. I'm a punk. He's a punk. I take drugs and get drunk. Take drugs and get drunk. I take drugs and get drunk. I'm a punk. I bet you think that I'm a cunning stunt. I'm a punk.
Curiously, the lead singer for the greatest Australian band of all time just happens to be Doug Mulray, whose recording of I'm a Punk was a big song in Sydney a few years back. In addition to his studio recording, Mulray performed this song to thousands of fans who've come to know him as a part-time rock and roll star because it seemed like a good idea at the time.
Cast of thousands in the studio today. We have the regular members of the Mulray Bunch.
The cast of thousands was locked into a studio 32 floors beneath, but we did manage to meet a couple of the more prominent members.
Here's a story of a lonely DJ who was coming up with pretty strange ideas.
He was born with ovaries and a womb and a malformed sexual organ. And they say that it was only sexual frustration that led him to dominating the world. This was how he compensated.
Here's a story of a girl named Lizzie, a boy genius and a traffic girl who barked, a mean banana and handsome whitey, but they never sparked.
Do you love her madly? Wanna be her daddy? Do you love her as she's walking out the door?
Till one day when these strangers met this DJ, and none of them could keep down any lunch. In an atmosphere of mutual aggravation, they were trapped and became the Mulray Bunch.
Can I be Janie now?
Like Andrew, the boy genius, who hosts one of Sydney's most creative television shows, Madame Zelda is a regular in this cast of thousands that, on a moment's notice, is brought into service. It's just dawn in Australia, and the Mulray Bunch is flying.
Oh, I'm getting very weary.
Thank you.
time zones around the world. The Z100 Morning Zoo.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, from high above the city, live from the penthouse studios of WWHTZ, the flamethrower. It's the nearly famous, highly outrageous, but never, ever contagious, Z Morning Zoo.
On the air everywhere.
The zoo crew from the net.
Good morning, New York.
Scott Shannon. A southern gentleman, and the one they call the radio genius.
I know you think I'm no match for you, baby. You like digging it rough on me, don't you? My. Back to the shack.
Nancy Martin, the editor of Playgirl magazine, the editor-in-chief of Playgirl magazine, who just posed nude for the October issue of Playboy, says the two most important qualities in a man are a flat stomach and a sense of humor.
What are you laughing about, Ross?
I'm not laughing.
Back to school with a brand new third college edition of Webster's New World Dictionary. Believe it or not, they got some new entries. That's hard. It's hard to get in there. New dictionary words?
Slang or not?
Slang. Couch potato.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's in the dictionary now. A chronic television viewer.
This is America's top-rated rock radio program. Its influence is substantial. Its format tight, slick, polished.
Hey, wait a minute. Ross, you're in the dictionary.
What?
Schlunk.
Just a little joke. Very funny.
Just a little joke.
Good morning, Z100.
Hello.
Good morning. How you guys doing
today? Just fine.
Who would this be?
You're talking to Mr. Bob from Levittown?
Yes, Bob.
How you guys doing today?
You just asked us that. We said fine. How may we help you?
We're still fine, Bob.
I think our show is vital because every day it has different dynamics. It has a different formula every day. I mean, you're liable to turn it on a Monday, and it'll be a nice, happy, warm show, a lot of listener participation. And then by Friday, we'll have a guest star like this Friday we got John Madden, or we might have someone from MTV on.
And it's topical, too. There's a lot of topicality to the show.
You never know what he's going to knock over.
It depends on the news each day as to what we're going to talk about, too.
Sagittarians, there's a dark spot in your past that's going to come back to haunt you unless you clear it up right now.
Capricorn, professional behavior is crucial to your personal advancement. Make sure you're on time, well-rested, and in control.
Aquarians, your life is just a dream today, so indulge in some of your favorite fantasies.
Pisces, you've got more power than you realize. Don't be afraid to throw your weight around.
At 7:19, those are your official zoo horoscopes. Remember,
don't leave home without it.
By the way, Taylor Dane ran into Prince while she was in Europe. He was playing a club, and she was coming back from the ladies' room, and he happened to see her. He said, "Hey, babe, what's your name?" She said, "I'm Taylor Dane from the U.S. He said, "Woo!" So supposedly he's going to write a song for her next LP.
They'll be coagulating, huh?
Yeah, I think that's what he had in mind.
Oh, yeah. You seem to always be
says that he was drunk on more than 2 gallons of beer when he proposed and lacked the mental capacity.
Being slick means being rehearsed. Being rehearsed means having a support staff that understands timing and delivery.
Hefty, 200, put it back in there. 230-pound wife Lisa sat on his face and chest. On his chest and face.
Broadcasting from what he calls the penthouse of the Gorilla Building, Scott looks out at a city full of surprises. After all, where else could you find a museum that's actually an aircraft carrier with a flight deck full of fighter jets? Where else but New York City?
I need you now more than you'll ever know.
it's time for that popular news feature on the Z Morning Zoo, News from the Boonies.
One of the zoo's most often imitated trademarks is its handling of unforgettable news stories. Indeed, of this idea is that you're apt to hear stories about almost any
flames skipped across the forest. They jumped into a nudist colony where the holiday frolicking was right in full swing. The relaxing nudists had to call the fire department and run from the flames. They barely got out with, you'll pardon the expression, the skin on their backs. Firefighters said they really didn't know where the colony was until they spotted two naked women waving to them on the side of the road. One firefighter was quoted as saying, "We knew that we'd either found the fire or we were in for a great Labor Day picnic."
And this tragic story just in from Nashville, a 32-year-old man from Nashville says he wants to end his month-old marriage because he was drunk when he walked down the aisle. And besides that, his 230-pound wife sat on him and forced him to marry her. Poor Willard Roberts says that he was drunk on more than 2 gallons of beer when he proposed and lacked the mental capacity to enter into a marriage contract. When he woke up, he found out his wife was way too fat. Now, before he realized what he had done, Willard got cold feet, and that's when his 230-pound wife, Lisa, sat on his chest and face until he agreed to go right down to the courthouse. Oh, Lord. Bet he couldn't hear the stereo. After they were married, a taxi took him home to his house and then dropped her off at her home. The two haven't seen each other since that day. He says he thinks the marriage should be annulled. Now, the question is, which one of our many zoo drops will fit this?
The zoo's secret is its creator and the devices he employs to deliver a program to an audience of some 2.5 million. Scott Shannon isn't from New York, but somehow he has found or uncovered the essence of this city, and in doing so has become the king, who every morning broadcasts from high atop the Empire State Building. The zoo may be imitated around the world, but just as there's only one gorilla building, there's only one zoo.
Yeah, I wondered whether her sitting on his face was a method of consummating the marriage, Scott.
Could have been. You never know.
Good morning, Montreal, or Montreal, as they say in Winnipeg. This is Emo Phillips. And just like you, I'm listening to Terry DeMonte and the Spirit, Shom FM.
From 97.7 FM in Montreal. Nice to have you with us this morning. It's part of the morning extravaganza. Tommy Schnurmeck.
Meet the man Montreal believes is the guy next door. You can trust him. He's the sort who you would imagine has a big dog, loves kids, and tells good jokes. And somehow, in a city that's both French and English, Terry DeMonte is the consummate radio star.
So let's start with, I think it's Rod. Rod, are you there?
Yep.
Rod, what's your last name?
Smiley.
Smiley?
Yep.
It's really Smiley.
No way, really?
Yeah.
Okay. So you've never heard a joke about your last name before then?
Not at all.
Right. Ted has been taking French lessons, so we want him to start.
Alors.
That's it. How long have you been taking French lessons?
Since May.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
They're going well, then, are they?
Well, no, actually, they are going well. I just need to practice more. But at least I know how to, like, I don't make mistakes that I used to make. Like, one time I went into a restaurant in Lévis, Quebec.
Mm-hmm.
This was when I was a totally unilingual anglophone.
Yes.
And I was driving to New Brunswick, and I decided I'll stop and get a coffee to go. And I said to myself, how do you order a coffee to go in French? And I thought, one for the road.
Right.
So I said, est-ce que je peux avoir un café pour la rue? Well, did she laugh? And she she said, attendez, attendez, and she ran back to the kitchen and she dragged the cook out and she said, encore, encore. I said it again and he laughed.
Monkey do, right beside a riverboat gamble. Right again, my jizz flow through my head. Say I wanna be.
Is he there? Well, you know what he's doing? He's rehearsing for us. He's
that he could have picked to be early. This morning would have been the good one.
They call themselves the Spirit of Montreal, and as presumptuous as this claim may seem, the city embraces the radio station both for its music and for its sense of history.
Should be discreet.
CHOM was among the first FM radio stations to be progressive with rock and roll, and for a time even tried broadcasting in French and English.
My dog ate my homework. The police pulled me over. My alarm didn't go off.
You're dead, Tommy.
No, there's no.
The clock isn't
working. How about the clock didn't work enough? No, it's true. I've been here. I've been here since Schwoos. I get in there.
Since Schwoos?
Broadcasting in both languages lasted only for 18 months. The experience reinforced the station's position as the Spirit of Montreal.
Okay, hang on a second. All right?
Here, where two cultures meet, it's interesting to find that music, good music, knows nothing of the language barrier.
Right now in downtown Montreal, it's 20 degrees.
Cindy, how are we doing on the roads there?
It's so slow.
I see tout seul au fond d'un bar d'une ville lointaine. Tu fuis les gens et les regards, mais un chasseur de
vie. You were in the lounge? Yeah, he's sitting in the lounge. He's got come in, laugh, put on a tie, right? Sit back with his paper. And every while, so, you know, so plenty of time, I stroll in late. And this is the thanks I get. Whose is this?
So many textures to this city. So much history. The French attitude is everywhere.
Le grand patron va parler.
We were doing some painting. And I started painting a rock. And it sort of looked like a dog, so I called it Rock Dog. And since then, Rock Dog is the name for our man's mind.
The people in Montreal, I find, are more radio-oriented than people in other cities I've worked in. If you work on a radio station, you're better known than you are in a lot of other cities if you worked in an equally popular station. If you're part of a morning show, it seems to really, people seem to be really extremely loyal to certain morning radio stations. I think that has a lot to do with it. That's why it's fun to work. I think because CHOM's been here since 1969, probably one of the first rock stations in the country to go on the air. And we call ourselves the Spirit of Montreal, and that sounds corny, but we're a really good reflection of the community, and I think that's an important ingredient to radio station. I think CHOM's had that since they went on the air in 69.
Well, you know I can be found sitting alone. If you can come around, at least please telephone. But don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Baby, if I made you mad,
and we have a lot of fun. Yeah, they let us do pretty much what we want, and it's really loose. As you guys could see, it was pretty loose, and we do anything we want, and convention is not part of the show.
We're hoping to say the F word next week.
It's fun.
Yeah, fun.
Oh, that's what I meant.
Of course. Don't stop thinking of me. Don't make me feel this way. Come on over and love me. You know I want you to stay. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Let's walk down to the preacher. Let's say
je m'appelle Edouard Loiseau. Which is translated loosely to Ted Berg.
I am Ted Berg.
Bonne journée, Ted.
Bonne journée.
Toi aussi.
Toi aussi.
Eat it too much.
The unbelievable west coast of Canada. This is 99.3 The Fox, Vancouver's home of rock and roll.
99.3 The Fox with Barney Bentall and the legendary Hearts.
Woo!
I like the look in girls' eyes, actually. That's it.
I like the seagulls.
These young men admiring the seagulls and the landscape are Canada's Olympic wrestling team, obviously in training.
That's a fabulous new West Coast release from Barney Bentall and the legendary Hearts. A great new album and something to live for, and it's
when
C. Nice
Fox began broadcasting rock and roll in the 60s, being hip was the first order of business. From those early ideas about radio programming came a reputation that has stuck, because today being hip is still something the station maintains is important to their sound.
Unbelievable West Coast. Hang in there, the Laverne and Shirley of West Coast Radio. Liz and Valor up next.
It's 2:05. I'm Liz McKinney. Valor Ambrose here. Quite a weekend, huh, Valerie?
Unbelievable weekend between the Abbotsford Air Show and all that incredible beach weather. It was just
this relationship between two women has taken hold in Vancouver and developed into quite a daily routine. Often the exchanges between Liz and Valerie are off the wall. Things just kind of pop out. Things about men, about women, about anything you'd expect not to hear on the radio.
Coming up next.
They just threw us together because Liz was available to do the afternoon shift, and I just was available to do the afternoon shift, so there we were.
We got a lucky break, really, is what happened, because it was supposed to be temporary all along, and we kept... For almost 4 months, we were told, well, it's temporary, and then we did a good job, and it's not temporary anymore.
You get a sense that this is a neat place for a big city, and much of what Valerie and Liz deal with is a city at play.
We're very natural on the air, both of us.
And indefinable chemistry, I think. When we first met 2 years ago, I walked into the building, and we just sort of clicked right away. We can start out having the worst day in the whole world.
Yes.
We do our first break at 2:20, and the energy just starts to build and build and build and build. And by 6 o'clock, we need a cigarette and a shower, basically.
Nobody sat us down and said what to do and what not to do. Consequently, we got in a lot of trouble with some of our bits, but we were pretty much given free rein, and we developed as we felt we should, and that's, I think, what our success is.
Yeah.
Giggly, and you know, we try to stay away from being like girls and stuff. We talk like guys might, you know. I mean, we're just the same as everybody. We try not to be like women, is what we try not to be. We don't want to be butch or anything, but we certainly don't want to be women. We just want people to think of us as people, as personalities or whatever, friends.
Right, yeah.
Afternoon friends on the radio. A pair of women who, whether they realize it or not, are licensed to be hip. London is a living museum. And although this notion is not lost on even one,
of its 10 million citizens. People here, especially young people in the streets, tend to focus on today.
And Capital Radio, 95.8 FM, our current record winners, Bross, and maybe the challenger. It's up to you on the phones, 484-5255, the new single from Terence Trent D'Arby.
Now, you're off school at the moment?
Yeah.
Just 15 years old, yeah?
Yeah.
Have you been taking any exams then?
Well, we just had my fourth year exams, but nothing, you know, not GCSEs or anything.
Not the dreaded GCSEs.
No.
My feet in the Capital Radio foyer. Glenn Medeiros has just arrived. He's signing copies of his brand new single, and he'll be here for about 30 minutes before he guests on The Way It Is tonight at 7 o'clock. If you want Glenn Medeiros to sign your record, Capital Foyer is the place to be. You know where we are, and he's here for about another 30 minutes, but you'll have to be quick.
Joanna.
Capital is an institution. Its studios are as much a part of English music as Wembley. On this day, John Cleese and Jefferson Starship were also among the visitors who managed to squeeze their way through a lobby full of fans just waiting for a glimpse of somebody famous.
On the train, Southern Region has a few non-runners. Victoria to Dartford, the 444. London Bridge to West Sutton, the 449. Victoria to Uckfield, the 502. Cannon Street to Dartford via Sidcup.
So many influences from Europe, Asia, and America. Still, Londoners seem undeterred in their belief that their city is home to whatever is hot, or what Capital calls mega.
The Kenny Everett Show. Yes, Kenny Everett. Bon vivant, raconteur, greatest DJ in the world, and liar.
A bad week for breaking promises, but a good week for breaking wind.
You think you got it all set up. I think it's jolly. I think that's what it is. We never get serious. I mean, that bit of classical music I just played, I made sure I only played about 20 seconds of it, because I think London people are basically jolly, and we try and keep up with them.
That's right.
Would you excuse me? I have to speak on the wireless through this microphone with this hairy condom. Paul, come in and chatter at me. I'm gonna tear your playhouse down. Pretty soon, I'm gonna tear your playhouse down.
Roll my room. Read my mug. Radio Malmahus.
I just found it lying around.
Oh, that's some kind of Swedish station.
There's an interloper here from another radio station.
Kenny Everett pushes hard against what can or cannot be said or performed on the radio. His following is loyal, and his style, way out there.
You don't need to go abroad, just listen to us.
Heart you use is blade toy.
I see you've been licking the backs of your knees again.
Yes.
Right about one, folks. So what you gonna do when you look up one day and see your playhouse somebody die? I'm gonna dance.
Playhouse down.
Well, that's page two of the show finished with. Hey, we've got a special bank holiday treat for you this Monday, an extra day of Capital Gold. Yes, ladies and gentle phones, we'll be coming at you for one whole more day. Isn't that exciting? Andrew Gardner said once that he had to sit in front of a mirror in his house to rehearse the name of this African king called Abubakar Tafawa Balewa.
Abubakar Tafawa Balewa.
Tafawa Balewa.
Right.
Abubakar Tafawa Balewa, because he knew he would have to use him a lot on the news. So he sat there, Abubakar Tafawa Balewa, Abubakar Tafawa Balewa, Abubakar Tafawa, right, got it! And he went on the news, and somebody shot the bugger.
Knife, a fork, and memories. I like to see it all. You didn't leave me anything that I can understand.
I forgot to do Gwen of Kidbrook's star sign. Do you remember what sign she was, Carol? Pisces. Thank you, Carol. Well, Pisces-born people tend to have masses of courage, energy, and underarm hair. Not renowned for their sense of humor, they find it hard to
The Capital Radio audience is enormous. On a weekly basis, about 4 million tune in to a sound that's sometimes hard-edged, sometimes soft, sometimes cynical, and often full of social conscience. But always, as Londoners say, the sound is crucial, which roughly translated means it's hot.
You didn't leave me anything that I can.
Plan where during the last record we pack and leave while the news is playing, and we're out on the street and in the car by the time the end of the news comes on. Sometimes I go home so fast I turn on the radio at home and I'm still talking.
You're listening to the Q Morning Zoo on Toronto's best rock, Q107.
It's 9:15, and we'd like to say hi. It's the Q Morning Zoo. We're doing the nighttime thing tonight because this show is X-rated, and we can't do it in the morning.
Yes.
So we thought we'd do a nighttime show. But we've asked a few questions here, and we'll see if we can get some answers. Who's on the line, Q107?
Hi, this is Jason calling from Toronto. How you doing?
Jason, loved your last movie, by the way, with the hockey mask and everything.
Excellent stuff.
Excellent movie. How many people have you brutally hacked to death and tormented before death now? What's your question, Jason?
Well, tell you the truth, I was sitting here, I turned on the radio, and I heard the familiar Q Morning Zoo thing start up. You made me look at my watch. What are you guys doing on in the evening?
That's exactly, yeah. Jason. We're trying to drive you out of your mind.
Well, see, boy, Jason, it's working. You know, next thing you know, they'd be fitting me with a restricting white sports jacket and in a little rubber room going me, me, me all the time.
Going what? Going what?
Hey, Jason. Have a nice day.
As the Canadian summer winds down, Jesse Dillon decides to do a late night version of a morning show. This celebration of the end of summer is not without precedent. In radio, anything imaginable can find its way onto the air. Tonight's no exception. Toronto lies 30 floors below, unsuspecting.
Hi there, who's
Hello.
On the line?
Crazy Larry from Oakville.
Crazy Larry.
You must have very nice parents to name you Crazy. And what's your answer or question?
Well, my answer is to your question. You wanted to know why you wrap gerbils in masking tape.
Yes,
because duct tape is for ducks.
Good answer.
Thank you. Have a nice weekend.
Thank you very much.
Don't go changing to try and please us. You're going to want to bundle up tonight because it is unseasonably cold weather we've been having. You know, for once, and I've got to say this, for once Environment Canada was right. We had a terrible weekend.
And as we check the weather radar screen, we can see that there's a guy down on Yonge Street selling fake Rolex watches.
Actually, that's an Eskimo, and he's chewing underwear out of beaver pelts.
Ooh.
Getting ready for the cool winter season, which is upon us.
What's clear in all this is that Dylan's program is popular because it's nonsense. Everything is fair game and all topics are openly discussed, from important Canadian issues like slaughtering maple trees to little known but important facts about gerbils. You can have a cage in Queens, down in New Orleans, and take a movie star who drive a Presley Merkaz.
Chop down a tree and destroy the boathouse.
You chop down what kind of tree?
A maple tree.
A maple tree.
Canada's heritage.
Yes.
A maple tree that you cut down.
And it didn't even scream.
You probably brutally tormented it before death.
No, we chopped it down after it had died in its sleep.
Behind, and as I look at Mr. Sports update here, the
even Jesse Dillon must reckon with Toronto's passion for sports. As a crew billed as the Sports Pals seizes the moment for big news of the local baseball team.
Eat my dust. That's it. So we'll be seeing you a little later on. That's a sports wrap up for the day. Mm-hmm. And now it's time to take you through the night, Toronto. Greatest city in the world with Q107. All right. Oh, nice shirts. How are they going to finish this year?
Yeah, really. They probably won't finish.
Zookeeper Jesse Dillon, along with my wife, Jean Belitis. We're out of the closet now. Might as well, go ahead, confess.
Yes, we are. We're in a larger closet now. Wow. It's quite
a
nice, actually.
Closet.
Marianne's here, the one with no last name. Now, we're here doing a nighttime thing. Well, we really can't tell you, but let's take a phone call right now. Q, good evening.
Hello.
Yeah, hello.
Bob the Mad Trucker.
It's Bob the Mad Trucker.
Like so many successful radio programs, this one is full of well-placed foils, people who provide great sport and take the brunt of a good joke. Tonight, it's Bob the Mad Trucker. The telephone makes radio instantaneous. It allows the show to be anywhere and everywhere in seconds and creates an environment that has clearly taken Toronto by storm. On the street, they say that Jesse and his crew, including the one they call Jojo, the dog-faced boy, are way out there. Clearly, this is not the place for the sensitive, serious type.
We want to make love to Anne Marie.
What are you, a prairie farmer? Get out of here.
Were you from Regina?
Right, yes.
It's time to
get out of here.
Over to Rock and John.
We're being physically removed from the radio station.
But we would like you to join us on the Morning Zoo. It's time to hand the night over to Rock and John because the night is, well,
thank you, Jess.
We don't want her. You can have her. She's too dark for me.
And too bad.
And she is. Johnson Gallagher, my two-headed sports pal, is here as well.
Exactly. It's the World Wrestling Federation tag team of Gallagher and Derringer to rock the night away. I love when I do that.
Really, very little has changed since Marconi's wireless received that first broadcast in 1901. We still employ the same basic technology, and around the world, radio is still presented by people in small, darkened rooms who sit anonymously behind microphones, letting their imaginations run wild.
Okay, Keith, hang on a second, all right?
All right,
hang on.
I'd like to welcome Michael French and the film crew from Canada.
Oh, yeah, that's it, guys.
From Vancouver, British Columbia. They're taping the zoo for an upcoming Canadian television special. This is radio. You got.
You can't nod, Michael.
Move this part, Michael.
You have to talk, Mike.
What is it?
Canadian television special air in Canada beginning the 21st of September.
There you go.
What's it called?
Walk Around the Clock.
All right, you're not going to put us on with Anne Murray, are you? That's okay. Not Anne Murray, though. No Anne Murray.
What happened?
Look at that.
You broke it. Oh!
It's the film crew just broke the record.
So we invite this film crew in because we're making a movie. You know, it can't be a great crew when the film costs $1.50 a three.
But more importantly, we've swelled our numbers with an extraordinarily charming group of Canadian gentlemen who are filming rock and roll stations all over the world. You may have heard Paul Holmes mention this in the mid-dawn hour. And it's lovely to have you with. Gentlemen, officially, welcome on behalf of all of us here at Triple M. The plus elegant du monde, designer radio. Your Uncle Doug Couturier in residence. Oh, don't talk French. Where are they from? They could be from Quebec. Are you from Quebec? Oh, no, I'm sorry then. That was something of a faux pas on my part. That's like telling that other joke about why Parisian streets are tree-lined to Frenchmen, isn't it?
Why is that?
So the German army can march in the shade.
There's one person on this show that never gets it wrong. This woman.
It's 11:45 a.m.
She's never wrong. Japanese. So, are we doing an interview afterwards? Or is this it? Oh, I see. How exciting. I didn't know you were going to spring this on me, you rat.